with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger? To hang out with us. What's up, danger? What's up, danger?
You wrecked your carriage. On the count of Monte Cristo.
Mr. Havendop, may I present the Count of Monte Cristo?
I beg your pardon?
Fafendop. Zona Fafendop.
Oh, Fafendop. Very unusual, isn't it?
Can't we go a little faster?
Surely. Hold on. Tighter.
Man, after great effort, I, Hercules Schneider, have found you the only carriage in Petsch. Of course, the horses may not be the best in the world.
Can they walk?
Oh, yes, madame.
That's all that's necessary. Point them towards Paris and start the moving.
Tonight, madame?
Certainly tonight.
But it's dark.
You don't say. It usually is at night.
Paris is the other way. You're looking back towards Lichtenberg.
Yes, I know. I used to think it the most beautiful country in the world. Are you staying long in Petsch?
No, I'm on my way to Lichtenberg on business. But about 5 o'clock this afternoon, it became a real pleasure trip. I'm sure you weren't able to find a carriage.
You were right. No carriage.
But we must find one.
No carriage. That's too bad. But after all, you do have one because I sent for mine. You haven't told me the object of your journey, but I know it must be urgent. Therefore, it's only right that I replace your carriage with mine to save you further delay. Besides, the road isn't safe for a young girl traveling alone. Anything can happen.
You're quite right. You're sure you don't mind a very early start?
Oh, not at all. The horses and I will be waiting with the dawn.
Dawn? Haven't you had enough driving and excitement for one day? You will forgive us, won't you?
Oh. Good night.
Yes.
Oh, well, good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night, Miss Pfaffendorf.
What are you doing?
Getting out of here. I've got a carriage and it's waiting downstairs.
You mean you...
I lied to him. Of course I lied to him. It was the only way to get rid of him. That young man makes a career of helping people who are in trouble get into more trouble.
But he's so nice, I feel guilty deceiving him.
Zona.
be changed. And it's a long way to Paris.
Soldiers! Lichtenberg soldiers! See that nobody leaves this room. Look here, fellow. There's a carriage waiting outside. For whom?
This is not Lichtenberg. I don't know how you crossed the frontier, but you've no right to ask me questions.
For whom is the carriage waiting?
Two ladies. Guests. Ladies of quality. Their carriage met with an accident and they...
Where are these two ladies of quality?
In the parlor, at the top of the stairs.
How dare you force your way into this room?
My orders are to escort you back to Lichtenberg, Your Highness. I am also instructed to secure a certain letter you are carrying to the Emperor of the French.
Must I remind you I'm the Grand Duchess of Lichtenberg and command my own person?
I am under orders, Your Highness. The letter, if you please.
I think her Royal Highness said she commanded her own person.
Who are you?
My friend here will introduce me.
Please don't!
Don't worry. My father was the best swordsman in France.
Schneider had been 20 years younger, the whole Lichtenberg army couldn't have taken her away from here.
What kind of a country is it when common soldiers lay hands on their own queen?
From the tales I hear, the days are as black as nights in Lichtenberg.
Oh, poor little Grand Duchess. A crown is a pretty heavy load for so young a head and so beautiful. The saints be praised. You are too brave a gentleman for those bandits to finish you.
You sure you feel right, sir?
Oh! Oh, there, there, poor gentleman.
Fafn. Fafn. Fafndop.
Run, get the doctor. He's out of his head.
No, never mind the doctor. Get me my carriage. My business in Lichtenberg is more urgent than I thought.
Zona, please. You've been pacing the floor for hours.
Von Neuhoff guilty. Branded a traitor, a criminal. And his only crime was in being my father's friend and mine.
He was more than my master. He was my friend. I would have given my life.
I understand how you feel, Stott. You were one of the few people he trusted.
Surely your Royal Highness has some plan to save him.
We must save him. How can they print such lies about him?
Because Gurko Lennon wrote them.
You may go, Stott, and Countess, if you don't mind. My roses. A thanks offering for your safe return.
General Lennon, I command you to set Baron von Neuhoff free at once.
Ordinarily, your wish would be my command. But von Neuhoff must die. I understand your grief. You are thinking of his services to you. But I must consider his danger to me.
I consider that you're having him murdered.
When the same thing happened to Caesar and Louis XVI, they didn't call it murder. They called it patriotism.
If Baron von Neuhoff is guilty, then so am I. Arrest me.
Arrest your Royal Highness. Unthinkable.
Then I have nothing more to say to you.
But there is something that I have wanted to say to you of the greatest importance for 3 years. If there is a difference between myself and other men, it is because I have dared to carry out my dreams. I dreamed of becoming master of Lichtenberg. Well, I am master. But I have other dreams, more personal. Some men are born under a star. My great dream has been to share my star with you.
What are you suggesting, General Lennon?
You should be able to recognize an honest proposal of marriage.
Marriage? With you? A liar, a murderer?
Say it, madame. A peasant. My peasant blood springs from the soil, and it runs rich and strong. History proves that blue blood has always benefited when mingled with red. Better than any man, I appreciate all you represent. Zona, you're a queen, but you're also a woman. Together we could build a greater Lichtenberg, could pass its glory on to our children.
Are you trying to say you love me, General Lennon?
I've been trying to say it for months. Even when you look through me rather than at me, I've often wondered when you look at me what you see.
I see a man I'd give my life to destroy. Get out.
I quite understand. The aristocrat is talking to the peasant. Good morning, Your Highness.
This paper has been printed for months. Now some of you people here know who printed it. My orders are to strip every house in this town until we uncover that press. I know who did it.
Who?
Whom?
I'll take you there.
Go ahead. Guards. In here. Smash in those windows. Clean out this place. Where's the press that printed this filth?
I don't know.
Where is it? In the basement, I heard it. Arrest him. Schwartz! Beiler! Come with me.
Steady hands.
All right, outside. So you're Kurt Merbeck, the man who prints the torch. Using your store as a blind to hide this press. It took me 3 months to hunt you down. You know the penalty for printing a newspaper without government sanction?
Yes. But the charges against Von Neuhoff are lies. There are some things not even the rope can strangle.
Take him away. Clean out this pigsty.
Stop! This is not law and order.
General Lennon gives the commands to Lichtenberg.
But this is tyranny!
You come with me. This way.
Not here. This is our own store.
I know it is. Where's your cellar?
Over here. Look what they've done. I'll pay them back for this.
Why did you think of coming here?
This is the one place they never think of looking for you.
Thank you for getting me away. But you shouldn't have helped me. They'll hunt you down, kill you on sight.
How about you?
Oh, I'm used to being hunted. They've been trying to catch us for months.
Well, ducking in here was simple. I wish I knew how we were going to duck out.
There is a way out.
Hmm?
Here. This is the way we sent the papers out.
Why didn't you escape this way?
Oh, we couldn't do that. These steps lead to some friends. We might have betrayed them. In the old days, this was a cemetery.
Looks as if it still is.
This is the place.
Who is this man?
He saved my life. Gentlemen, the printing press is destroyed. My father is arrested. Same thing would have happened to me, only for this man. Hess!
At least you escaped. I saw what you did, sir. That was enough to assure your welcome here. I saw what you did. That was enough to explain you being here.
I am Fritz Stoner, Lieutenant of the Household Guard. This is Lieutenant Schultz.
Lieutenant? I'm Edmund Dantes, sometimes called the Count of Monte Cristo.
Young Monte Cristo,
the richest man in Europe.
It's like meeting a legend, face to face. You're twice welcome.
Thank you for what you did.
Listen, everyone. Disaster has dealt us a second blow, a death blow. Gurko has given Zimmerman secret orders that Baron von Neuhoff is to die at midnight. When he dies, all that is good in Lichtenberg will die with him.
Von Neuhoff?
Yes. This is a picture of Baron von Neuhoff.
Where are you going?
Look, missed him. I won't.
Killing Gurko isn't the answer. I could have done that long ago. We must kill what Gurko represents.
Hey, yes, you're right.
You must have a high opinion of our country. Welcomed in a tomb with the news that our greatest man is to be assassinated and the knowledge that our Grand Duchess is a prisoner in her own palace.
Prisoner? But surely you intend doing something about it.
Easier said than done. Zonia is helpless without the support and counsel of von Neuhoff. To save her, we must save von Neuhoff first.
And von Neuhoff is in the palace dungeon, under a death watch.
As if an old man could dig his way out with his bare hands.
There is one chance. It is so slim it's impossible.
But we'll take any chance.
None of you can help me. I'd have to have someone in the palace. Someone beyond Gurkel's suspicion.
You men make me a little ashamed of myself. One hears of men like you, but never sees them. You're right. If von Neuhoff's to be saved, it must be from inside the palace. Perhaps I can qualify as the volunteer you need.
You? But how can you, a stranger, get in the palace?
By using a bank draft for 25 million francs as a calling card. Money has opened stronger doors. I'm in Lichtenberg because General Annan has applied to the House of Monte Cristo for a loan.
A loan?
Yes. Which I have just decided to grant. Gentlemen, I consider it a privilege to help you prove that the torch of liberty is difficult to extinguish.
You mean be one of us?
Mentally, I've been one of you since my first hour in this country.
My dear General Lenin, so good of you to receive me. Beastly business, this banking. What?
Do you know, you look like an entirely different person.
I hope the effect doesn't remain permanent. You know, I'm glad I thought of buying these glasses on the way back to the hotel. They add that last perfect touch. I wish I didn't have to do this.
I'd understand perfectly if you'd like to change your mind about going through with it.
Oh, I'm not worried about that. I was thinking of Her Royal Highness, Zona. After our meeting in Pet, she must have thought me a fool. And now when we meet again in the palace, I have to make her believe that I'm a bigger fool than she thought. I can't let her know the me I'd like her to know. And I can't let General Lanny know the me I'd like him to know. I'm getting a little confused. I'm beginning to wonder which me is me.
It'll take more than a few ruffles and a pair of eyeglasses to fool Gurko Lanin.
You'd be better off with a sword in your hand.
I'm afraid General Lanin would suspect a man who tried to get close to him with a sword in his hand.
What makes you so sure he won't suspect a fop?
A fop is a fool. And a fool enjoys a strange protection not shared by other men. No one takes a fool seriously.
You'll need protection if Gurko discovers your real purpose is to help Vanyuhov escape.
My dear Lieutenant Dorna, I'm sure I can convince General Lannan that the Count of Monte Cristo has absolutely no interest in a slimy old dungeon. Order my carriage. I'm a trifle late for this appointment. 4 days, to be exact.
Excellency, your carriage is waiting.
The Count of Monte Cristo to see your Excellency.
Monte Cristo, eh? So he decided to come 3 days after I'd expected him. If I was some sniveling prince, these bankers would come fawning to give me anything I wanted. If I didn't need his money to build up my army, I'd give His Excellency the Count of Monte Cristo a lesson in keeping appointments. Or I'd go out and bring him in. We shall have the pleasure of listening to another banker give us excuses instead of money.
My dear Count. The Count of Monte Cristo, Your Excellency.
Welcome to Lichtenberg, Your Excellency.
Thank you. Terribly sorry to be so late, but that's a weakness of mine. I once kept the Shah of Persia waiting 2 weeks. Oh. But at last I'm face to face with the great Gurko Lannan.
I would hardly allude to myself as great.
Oh, naturally not. That's a privilege reserved for your admirers. They say a cat can look at a king, so perhaps a humble banker can look at a hero. Do you mind my curiosity?
Not at all, but won't you sit down?
Only you knew how I simply adore men of action. Strong, self-made men with high ambition, who grasp life firmly and bend it to their will. My father was like that, you know.
Yes, I do know. A remarkable man.
Yes, I suppose he was. But I'm getting a little bored having him stuffed down my throat by everyone. Oh, don't misunderstand me. I loved him and all that, but I'll never forgive him.
Really? Why not?
Well, if only he'd endowed me with a little of his character, instead of all his money, I, too, might have been a man of action. But I'm not, so there you are.
Yes, but men of action can do nothing without the support of influential bankers.
Surely you must thrill to the knowledge that there is more power in your signature than there is in my sword.
Thrill?
I detest banking.
Why, at this moment, it's taken me away from Paris at the very height of the social season. If it wasn't for my intense interest in meeting you, I'd be very unhappy. However, here I am, so there you are. Now, let's get on to business. you applied to my banking house for a loan, I believe.
Yes, sir. 25 million francs.
25 million francs? Is that all? Why, I thought it was more.
Well, I...
However, we can discuss that later. Of course, I could give you a yes or no now, but that wouldn't be good banking. I've been taught to frown at a client. Put him off. Keep him dangling. So I'm afraid you'll just have to dangle a while. Filthy business, isn't it?
No hurry. No hurry at all. I wanted you to be thoroughly convinced that your loan would be a secure one. And I assure you...
Now. Don't try and get a decision out of me. I've already made one, but you must dangle.
I trust that during your stay you will be my guest here at the palace.
That's most considerate of you. I shall be charmed.
Colonel Simone, send for Lieutenant Dorna.
Yes, Excellency.
Oh, there were two things they told me to be sure and see in Lichtenberg, if I can remember them. Yes. Your lovely countryside and your Grand Duchess Zona. I hear she's very beautiful.
It will be my pleasure to present you to her Royal Highness. Perhaps tonight. We dine at 8:30.
Charming, charming.
Lieutenant Dorna. This is the Count of Monte Cristo, my personal guest. See that he's given one of the royal apartments, and that everything is done for his comfort.
Thank you, General. Till 8:30, then?
A bit of a fool, Zimmerman, but rich. I think if we handle him carefully, we'll get what we want.
Zona, will you stop wriggling? This is the fifth time I've gone through the motions of getting you dressed.
Are you sure I look all right?
If you mean, will he suspect that you haven't had a wink of sleep in 4 nights, the answer is no.
I remember he said he was coming to Lichtenberg on business, but I never dreamed he'd come here.
Will you please try to remember that you're a Grand Duchess?
Darling, it's the first time in my life I haven't felt like one. He may be able to help us. A man like the Count of Monte Cristo must have powerful friends.
Baron von Neuhoff had powerful friends, and he's having his dinner in the palace dungeon. Perhaps his last dinner. I'm sorry. Come in.
Dinner is served at the pleasure of Her Royal Highness.
Thank you, sir.
Your Royal Highness, may I present the Count of Monte Cristo?
I'm happy indeed to welcome you to Lichtenberg.
Your Royal Highness, I can't tell you how honored I am to be here.
The Countess von Braun, the Count of Monte Cristo.
My dear Count.
Enchanted.
The Count of Monte Cristo is the last person I expected to receive here.
I hope Your Royal Highness won't think I'm presumptuous. It's terribly funny, but for a moment I had a feeling we'd met before. Perhaps it's because the Royal Highness reminds me of someone I once knew. Oh, the most beautiful woman I've ever seen. But of course, she was not the Grand Duchess of Lichtenberg. Oh, no. In fact, her name was Pfaffendorf.
What?
Yes, really, it was. Pfaffendorf.
Well, my dear Christo, you don't strike me as being the type of man who would let a beautiful woman escape him, even if her name was whatever it was.
Well, I did everything I could. I was even ready to joust for the fair lady's favor. And I'm not a very good jouster. But she rode off out of my life.
Shall we have dinner?
My dear General Lannan, it's so refreshing in this day of unrest to find a country where one firm hand dictates the national policy. Why, do you know, in France, it's come to the point where even a chimney sweep considers himself as good as a king.
In Lichtenberg, it is my policy to keep chimney sweeps in the chimneys.
Oh, chimney sweeps in the chimneys. Excellent, my dear General, excellent. Very funny fellow, isn't he?
I understand you're in Lichtenberg on business, Your Excellency.
Well, no, not exactly. You see,
he's too modest. Since 3 o'clock this afternoon, Lichtenberg is indebted to His Excellency in the sum of 25 million francs.
On the contrary, my dear General, I feel greatly indebted to you. It's such a privilege to meet a great man doing such great things for his country. One can't place a monetary value on achievement. Don't you agree, Your Royal Highness?
Gentlemen, I'll leave you to your cigars and port.
But I don't smoke, and my doctor assures me that port is the reason all Englishmen have the gout.
If you'll excuse me, I have a headache.
I'm afraid the ladies didn't enjoy their dinner.
Oh, really? I thought it very palatable.
I have to report that 10 o'clock inspection of the guard has been made.
10 o'clock? Excuse me. Must be the provincial atmosphere, but I have that drowsy feeling. Just right after a good dinner and before a good night's sleep.
Oh, I quite understand. Well, you must have had a very tiring day. Suppose we just say good night.
Ah, the perfect host, who knows the exact moment at which to say good night.
Attend His Excellency.
Schultz and I are ready. At 11.
11.
Splendid. That gives me exactly 58 minutes and 30 seconds. This way, Your Excellency.
If you don't mind, I think I'll go this way. And I don't need an attendant. Your Highness, what a pleasant surprise. But fresh air is, I believe, the best cure for a headache. May I?
You change characters quite easily. I saw you first as a cavalier. Now I see you in the role of a fop, flattering the ego of a man that your first personality should have every reason to despise. Just what is your true character?
Hmm? Oh, I'm a businessman. A banker, to be exact. I believe in making my clients feel superior to myself.
In Pet, you made me believe you were a chivalrous gentleman. I even cherish the memory of what you did that night.
I hope you believe it's my desire to add to that memory.
By lending General Lannan all the money he needs to completely destroy my country.
But loans are not based on sentiment, but on sound collateral.
And what collateral does he offer you?
A mortgage on the whole of Lichtenberg.
What you have bought is a partnership in his crimes against my people. From what I've heard of your father, he'd hardly be proud to know that his son had financed a tyrant and a traitor.
But perhaps I made this loan because I consider
consider you the most important part of my security.
How unfortunate. You should know that General Lannan does not include me in the collateral, for the reason that General Lannan has proposed marriage to me. Also on a business basis.
You know, you're even more beautiful when you're angry.
Good night.
At a time. Good night, beloved.
Therefore, I, Gorko Lannan, do impose the sentence of death by hanging upon the said Baron von Juhoff, and do order that the execution of this death warrant shall be carried out at 12 o'clock midnight, May the 10th.
Which is tonight, I believe.
Do you have anything to say?
Yes. You may deliver a last message to General Lannan. Tell him that if he hopes to bury loyalty to Zona of Lichtenberg in my grave, it will rise again to destroy him.
Guards!
Don't shoot. Just Lieutenant Donner reporting for duty, sir.
Well, for the rest of my life, I'm going to view all fireplaces with suspicion. But it's very useful.
My father and grandfather were officers of the Household Guard. They taught me a lot of useful things about this palace Gorko doesn't know.
Let's hope that fireplace is one of them. Are we ready?
As ready as the last hope can be.
But it's better than no hope at all.
I feel that I dragged you into this.
I galloped in.
We've one chance in 100 of getting to von Juhoff, to say nothing of getting him out.
That makes it a sporting proposition. Shall we go?
This way.
Where's Schultz?
Making his rounds. He'll join us below. The stairs have been forgotten for 50 years.
Let's hope they won't be remembered for another 50.
Schultz, in 1 minute the sentry will inspect von Neuhoff's cell. I'll meet you at the bottom of the stairs.
All right.
I better go in first. You'll be recognized on sight.
But you'd be recognized too.
No, I won't. I decided to create another character that General Lannan doesn't know. One I hope he never will.
It's the last night we'll have to do this. And good riddance. The trouble with this job, we're as much in jail as von Neuhoff.
Yes, but we aren't going to hang in an hour.
Nothing new. Sleeping like a baby.
Well, I wouldn't be sleeping like a baby.
You would if you were an aristocrat like von Neuhoff.
Well, let's have a look at him. Yeah, he's sleeping all right.
The minute we get von Neuhoff out, we make for the North Tower.
Please don't be alarmed. I'll have you out of here in a minute.
Who are you?
A friend.
Young man, it's madness.
If every prisoner thought that, there'd never be an escape. Come on, we're leaving.
Take this gun, sir. This way. Quick.
They bolted the door from the outside.
The turnkey. He's in trouble.
Then we're locked in.
Fire! 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 Fire!
Leads to the armory. There are guards there. This way. There's nothing beyond here. This is a blind corridor. Now it isn't even a sporting proposition.
The boys have been very foolish. There will be four of us on the scaffold now.
We haven't climbed those steps yet. What's that? The old sewer runs under here to the river. That's our way out.
Can't make it.
Won't move.
It's rusted in.
Let's all try one side. Fire into that bolt.
Guards off.
By the time they figure out where we are, we won't be there.
This way.
A traitorous swine.
Take more than fairy tales and goblins to explain this. Not even a man in a mask could disappear through these walls. Look at that. Footprints. Finger marks.
Disappeared through the walls.
You imbeciles! You stuffed dummies in uniform! The world knows that I considered von Neuhoff a special prisoner. Kept him in this dungeon where I could watch him to prevent his escape. And you have dared to humiliate me by permitting him to get away. The man you were guarding was to die at midnight. You two will die in his place.
But, Excellency, we're innocent.
Innocent or guilty, you will die. If only because I must show the bodies of more than one traitor to explain such an escape. See that my orders are carried out. Now, pick up that drinking.
Let me go, Excellency. Your life may be in danger.
With von Neuhoff at liberty, more than my life is in danger.
In here.
Woman, you have to go into sewers to find them.
Baron von Neuhoff!
Hans! Go back along the branch of the sewer that leads to the palace. Keep a close watch. We may have been followed.
This is indeed a happy day for us.
It's difficult for me to speak, because I never expected to see you again. And I shouldn't have, but for Monte Cristo. With a living proof that if justice is crushed in one land, men will spring to its defense in every land. For the spirit of justice creates a common brotherhood. Tonight you have dealt Kerkelanen a great blow. Not because you rescued a prisoner named von Neuhoff, but because you set free a man who was a threat to his ambition. But it's no victory. Kerkelanen is not defeated so easily. He's lost one prisoner, but he holds another far more important. Zona of Lichtenberg. Until she is free, we have done nothing.
But it will take an army to free her.
Yes, I know it will. Our one hope is still the French. Louis Napoleon is my friend. I leave tonight for Paris.
We'll see that you get safely out of the city.
Catacombs. Here are their footprints.
next door. Break it down.
Whoever he is, this torch is dangerous. He has a sense of humor.
Good afternoon, Your Royal Highness.
Good afternoon. Surprise me. You're quite agile for a banker.
Ah, but it wasn't the banker who climbed up here. I just couldn't resist the balcony, a beautiful girl, and the impulse. I've often thought a man can make a business of freeing caged birds. So many people who appear to be free are really prisoners.
You appear to be quite free.
Oh, but I'm not. I've been a prisoner from the moment I found you in your wrecked carriage. You're a prisoner, too. It's such a pity you have to be a Grand Duchess, when there are so many roads to be traveled, mountains to be crossed, happiness, laughter, all the things you could have if you weren't a Grand Duchess.
Who would give them to me?
I would. And I could, too, if you were really Zona Pfaffendorp, a girl on her way to Paris. Love could come riding up to her carriage, but it's almost impossible for love to pass the sentries at the doors of a palace.
The man I'd welcome wouldn't find it impossible to pass the sentries, nor would it be necessary for him to enter the palace. I'd go out to meet him. A man like the torch.
What, a ruffian, a masquerader?
A ruffian and a masquerader who's unselfish enough to risk his life for others. Such a man would dare take love in his hands, be its master.
Oh, you don't think I have daring, that I could be master?
Daring in sport, perhaps, master of money.
I was speaking of love.
That's to remind you I'm not Zona Pfaffendorp.
Oh, Your Royal Highness. Good afternoon. Insulting, isn't it? Must be a nasty sort, this torch fellow.
If I could only lay my hands on him.
Well, why don't you just reach out and grab him? You could, you know. My, I don't envy you. Too many problems. Always worried about von Neuhoff, Louis Napoleon, and now this torch, who seems to me to be just like some character out of a comic opera.
My dear Christo, at this moment, your comic opera character is a greater menace than the French. I appreciate how really dangerous he is. I've used the same weapons he's using against me. Why, this torch is more useful to von Neuhoff than a whole army corps. Overnight, he could become a hero, a popular leader whom the people would follow blindly. Mystery, excitement, daring, those are the things that the people admire.
Really? Oh, well, then you have to catch the fellow. You've made this torch sound very formidable.
Formidable? Well, he's too clever to be run down by a squad of pig-headed soldiers. But I have my own weapons. This torch has friends. Fellow conspirators, any one of whom would sell his soul for 25,000 kronen.
May I? A little closer.
officer, please. Thank you. Splendid. I'll double the reward. And furthermore, I'm willing to wager you that the fellow's nothing but a silly crackpot, with no more brains than I have.
The French ambassador.
Von Neuhoff certainly hasn't been letting any grass grow under his feet. I've been expecting him. Let him in.
Please excuse me. I find affairs of state simply horrid, and even more repugnant than banking.
His Excellency, the Marquis de Chantant.
Good afternoon, Your Excellency. Sit down.
I can carry out the instructions of my government standing. General Lennon, I'm instructed to inform you that my government recognizes Baron von Neuhoff as the legal representative of the government of Lichtenberg.
Oh, really?
Either you surrender Her Royal Highness, the Grand Duchess Zona, into the custody of the French government, or she will be liberated by force.
My dear Ambassador, I'm not as naive as that. To you, von Neuhoff may still be the head of the legal government of Lichtenberg, but I have Her Royal Highness, who is the government itself, and possession is 9 points of the law.
Very well. I will report your answer to my government.
May I ask Your Excellency a question?
Yes.
What would be the attitude of your government if Her Royal Highness announced her marriage with one General Lenin?
Impossible.
Not at all. If she thought that there was any danger to her people of a Russian invasion, she would do almost anything to save them from such a fate.
A Russian invasion?
Surely Your Excellency realizes that Russia is just as interested as France in using Lichtenberg as a buffer against Bismarck. I can understand the readiness of your government to support von Neuhoff against me, but is it as eager to support him against me and Russia? Good afternoon, Your Excellency.
Zona! Zona! The French ambassador just left and Gracco is furious.
That's because of Baron von Neuhoff. I knew something like that would happen as soon as he escaped. Oh, Mathilde, if we could only do something to help.
No, Zona, wait! Oh, there's a note attached.
To help Baron von Neuhoff and your people, you must escape.
A way has been planned.
Be at the postern gate, peasant dress, at 10 tonight, and trust the torch.
The torch? Maybe it's a trap of forgery.
No, it isn't. I know it isn't. Come in. Do you wish to see me?
Isn't it natural for a man to wish to see the woman who fills his thoughts?
You'll excuse me.
You may leave without an apology, my dear Countess. Your Royal Highness, I've never seen you so beautiful. You look almost happy.
My opportunities for happiness have been rather limited, General Lennon. I didn't expect another visit from you.
Did you think me the kind of man who was easily discouraged? Discouragement only makes me fight harder.
Does the kind of man you are take into consideration my feelings?
Zona, believe me, I desire your happiness above anything else in the world.
So you prove it by keeping me a prisoner, away from my friends, my people. Your kind of man, General Lennon, wouldn't hesitate to sacrifice even the woman he loved to his ambitions.
Would it be such a great sacrifice to share your throne, your life, with a man who loves you?
Could you marry a woman who despises you?
If she knew how much I loved her, she wouldn't despise me. My destiny has led me to this palace. And to you.
I've already told you, General Lennon. I wouldn't marry you under any consideration.
My object in coming here was to ask you to change that decision.
That has the sound of a threat. But if I don't...
At the moment, Your Royal Highness, it is only a suggestion.
Of what?
That I should be most unhappy to adopt another method of obtaining your consent. I have no wish to press you too closely. I shall return tomorrow at this hour for your answer. And in the meantime, I hope that it will add to your happiness to know this will be the longest night of my life.
Mathilde, Mathilde.
Yes? What happened? What did he want? Marriage. Only this time it was a demand. Mathilde, what'll I do?
You can get out of here.
Yes, yes, but how? We'll need help.
Start. That's it. Start. We can trust him.
You're right. Get him. Get him. Start. I know how greatly Baron von Neuhoff trusted you.
Yes, Highness.
He never doubted your loyalty.
Oh, no, Highness.
I want you to help me. You must help me.
Anything, Highness.
I'm trusting you with the whole of Lichtenberg.
The torch.
Somehow you must get a peasant costume for Countess von Braun and myself. I know what a risk you take, but I promise you the reward will also be great. Will you do this for me?
Yes, Highness, gladly.
Go then, hurry.
I flatter myself I've been of some small service to your excellency.
You've done well, Stott.
I also flatter myself I am fitted for much larger opportunities.
A man's advancement rests upon his ability.
Exactly. I'm about to prove my ability by accomplishing something even your excellency has found impossible. The capture of the torch.
What do you mean? Do you know who he is?
No. But I know where he'll be at 10 o'clock tonight.
Well, come on, out with it.
Did I mention, Excellency, that I'm an ambitious man? And I'm sure your Excellency will agree that a man who makes possible the torture's capture has demonstrated his right to larger opportunities, to say nothing of the financial reward.
You're right, Stott. What do you want?
I feel I could serve your Excellency to better advantage as, shall we say, chief of the secret police.
I've underestimated you, Stott. I admire a man who knows what he wants and how to get it. I think the man that runs down the torch should be chief of the secret police.
Thank you.
And now?
The torch has a rendezvous with Her Royal Highness at 10 tonight. He has planned her escape. If you set a trap at the postern gate near the servants' quarters, you catch not only the torch, but Her Royal Highness.
How do you know?
Your Excellency forgets. I also have Her Royal Highness's complete confidence. If I can be of any further service?
Cover every inch of the palace grounds with troops and keep them concealed until the torch walks into the trap.
Yes, Excellency.
I never realized how clever Stutt really was.
But this is only your signature.
Over it, write an order of the death of one Conrad Stutt.
But I thought...
If he will betray Her Royal Highness, he will also betray me. But do not carry out the order until after we've caught the torch.
Everything's arranged, Your Highness. There's a peasant car waiting outside the gate.
Stand where you are.
Stand clear.
Throw down your sword.
I'll be glad to give it to you.
Stay out, gentlemen. This is my pleasure. You handle your sword, you must be a gentleman.
My father was the best swordsman in France.
My father was the best swordsman in France.
Don't lie, I'll be back.
Monte Cristo.
After him.
Should be here, and now he's got away.
Start.
Yes, Your Royal Highness.
not to go anywhere or see anyone without my permission.
If you please.
Good evening, Your Excellency.
Good evening.
Are you badly hurt?
Oh, no, it's just a scratch.
I was worried about you, so I followed you here.
You came in without knocking?
Yes, I'm a spy.
Oh, now I understand. Well, what do you want, Stat?
You know, it's very difficult for a man who's always wanted everything to suddenly discover he can have everything he ever wanted. Just, what do you consider your life worth? For instance, it's worth 25,000 kronen to Gurko Lenin, dead or alive.
It's a miserly offer, don't you think? I'm worth much more to myself.
It is strange how one's sense of values changes. Before I discovered you were the torch, I thought 25,000 kronen was a fortune. But now, I realize you could toss that amount to a beggar. And I do not have to beg.
You're a very clever man, Stat. Would you mind telling me how you found out about this?
I've always enjoyed the complete confidence of a Royal Highness.
Oh, I see. And of course you betrayed her to General Lenin.
Suppose we say I took advantage of my opportunities, hmm?
Oh, I'm a trifle nervous.
Yes, I can understand.
I also take advantage of my opportunities.
I just can't believe it. Monte Cristo, the torch. And I thought him nothing but a young idiot with more money than brains.
I called him worse than that.